Good afternoon. My name is Yili Yang. I have been working with Woodward Climate Research Center for six weeks on this project. And Woodward Climate Research Center is a world-leading climate research think tank in the U.S. So climate changes are getting more and more attention recent years, especially after the last announced COP26 summit in Glasgow. So what I do in this project is to map a permafrost soil landscape called abrupt permafrost soil in northern Siberia. So on the slide, you can see a typical one here. And currently those features, those landscapes are not well mapped. So we don't know the occurrence and the impact it brings to the Arctic. Our aim is to map those landscapes, and so we can know the occurrence and the impact it brings to the Earth. So these are images which has 4 meters resolution in Siberia, northern Siberia, in the Arctic. And we are going to train our models to identify those thought-long features on those images. So the approach we took is we use Google Earth Engine to extract those images and those labels of the thought-longs and train those data with TensorFlow on a model called a convolutional neural network build a robust model to find those source lumps. So now let's look at how the model performs on the test set. So on the original image, we have a source lump feature that is verified by experts, which is in a circle. And we have our model produced a probability map, which shows the predicted probability has a really high concentration on the same location as is on the original image. So this shows our model has really good ability to predict those source lump features from the satellite images. So in order to understand how good our model performed across the whole dataset, we use a metric called intersection over union. So basically this matrix measures how good is the prediction overlaps with the ground truth. So our model intersection over union is 0.58, which reaches the highest intersection over union of a very recent paper of Nitz et al. Across different regions. And also they are using very similar approach in the same region as we did. So basically, our model is very good comparing with those publicated results. And our model also able to find some new and unidentified source lumps on the map in northern Siberia. So for example, these ones are all new source lumps that previously unidentified. So the impact of this project is first, we demonstrated the capability of a deep neural network model to predict permafrost source lumps, and we revealed the potential of applying it across the Arctic region. And also it saved hundreds of hours and even thousands of hours comparing with manually labeling those permafrost source lumps and marking them out. So the future scope of this project is we can upscale the model from only Siberia to the entire Arctic. And also we understand the impact of global warming on the Arctic biome. Also, we will be able to monitor and estimate permafrost soil carbon emission. And ultimately, we will be able to improve our carbon budget model to make the world greener. Yeah, thanks very much.